embark on an enchanted journey. We will explore some of the most powerful ancient secrets of stratagem. Not only do these stratagems pertain to war, but may also be incorporated into your everyday life to render opportunity of gain and prosper wherever you may be, and thus ultimately defeat the enemy. Sun Tzu, otherwise known as Master Sun, was an ancient Chinese military general, strategist, and philosopher during 544 through 497 BC. Honorably credited with some of the most impactful strategy of war, Sun Tzu widely influenced military strategy throughout Western and Eastern philosophy. Master Sun is a historical legend among the Chinese, Asian, and many different cultures around the world. Cannot enter into alliances until we are acquainted with the designs of our neighbors. Thus, the expert in battle moves the enemy and is not moved by him. The whole secret lies in confusing the enemy so that he cannot fathom our real intent. Knowing the enemy enables you to take the offensive. Knowing yourself enables you to stand on the defense. Thus, it is that in war that the victorious strategist only seeks battle after the victory is won, whereas he who is destined to defeat first fights and afterwards looks for victory. Bravery without forethought causes a man to fight blindly and desperately like a mad bull. Such an opponent must not be encountered with brute force, but may be lured into an ambush and slain. The greatest victory is that which requires no battle. Strategy without tactics is the slowest route to victory. Tactics without strategy is the noise before defeat. Never venture. Never win. Who wishes to fight must first count the cost. The worst calamities that befall an army arise from hesitation one may know how to conquer without being able to do it. You can ensure the safety of your defense if you only hold positions that cannot be attacked. The art of war is self-explanatory. The whole secret lies in confusing the enemy so that he cannot fathom our real intent. Who does not know the evils of war cannot appreciate its benefits. You can ensure the safety of your defense if you only hold positions that cannot be attacked. First, lay plans which will ensure victory, and then lead your army to battle. If you will not begin with stratagem, but rely on brute strength alone, victory will no longer be assured. If there is a disturbance in the camp, the general's authority is weak. The good fighters of old put themselves beyond the possibility of defeat, and then waited for an opportunity of defeating the enemy. When the outlook is bright, bring it before their eyes, but tell them nothing when the situation is gloomy. Imagine what I would do if all I could do, I can. There is no instance of a country having benefited from prolonged warfare. Rewards for good service should not be deferred a single day. Conceal your dispositions, and your condition will remain secret, which leads to victory. Show your dispositions, and your condition will become patent, which leads to defeat. Rewards for good service should not be deferred a single day. The art of war is of vital importance to the state. Do not take opportunity to advance and reward the deserving. Your subordinates will not carry out your commands, and disaster will ensue. Treat your men as you would your own beloved sons, and they will follow you into the deepest valley. What the ancients called a clever fighter is one who not only wins, things, but excels at winning with ease. Move not unless you see an advantage. Use not your troops unless there is something to be gained. Fight not unless the position is critical. There are not more than five primary colors: blue, yellow, red, white, and black. Yet, in combination, they produce more hues than can ever be seen. Begin by seizing something which your opponent holds dear. Then he will be amenable to your will. Engage people with what they expect. It is what they are able to discern and confirms their projections. It settles them into predictability patterns of response, occupying their minds while you wait for the extraordinary moment that which they cannot anticipate. The supreme art of war is to subdue the enemy without fighting. Whether it is an advantageous position or a disadvantageous one, the opposite state should be always present in your mind. He who advances without seeking fame, who retreats without escaping blame, whose one aim is to protect his people and serve his lord, the man is a jewel of the realm. If his forces are united, separate them. For knowledge cannot be gotten from ghosts and spirits, cannot be had by analogy, cannot be found out by calculations. It must be obtained from people. People who know the conditions of the enemy. A clever general therefore avoids an army when its spirit is keen, but attacks when it is in sluggish and inclined to return. This is the art of studying moods. So long as victory can be attained, stupid haste is preferable to clever dilatoriness. Be where your enemy is not. Attack is the secret of defense, and defense is the planning of attack. If quick, I survive. If not quick, I am lost. This is death. All warfare is based on deception. Let your plans be dark and impenetrable as night, and when you move, fall like a thunderbolt. There are not more than five musical notes, yet the combinations of these five give rise to more melodies than can ever be heard. are rules which must not be followed. Armies which must not be attacked. Towns which must not be besieged. Positions which must not be contested. Commands of the sovereign which must not be obeyed. To win 100 victories in 100 battles is not the acme of skill. To subdue the enemy without fighting is the acme of skill. Do not repeat the tactics which have gained you one victory, but let your methods be regulated by the infinite variety of circumstances. It is only the enlightened ruler and the wise general who will use the highest intelligence of the army for the purposes of spying and thereby achieve great results. When you surround an army, leave an outlet free. Do not press a desperate foe too hard. If ignorant of both your enemy and yourself, you are certain to be in peril. By reinforcing every part, he weakens every part. Mystify, mislead, and surprise the enemy. The general who does not advance to seek glory or does not withdraw to avoid punishment, but cares only for the people's security and promotes the people's interests, is the nation's treasure. King is only fond of words and cannot translate them into deeds. If you know the enemy and know yourself, your victory will not stand in doubt. If you know heaven and you know earth, you may make your victory. Anger may in time change to gladness. Vexation may be succeeded by content. But a kingdom that has once been destroyed can never come again into being. Nor can the dead ever brought back to life. In the midst of chaos, there is opportunity. Victorious warriors win first and then go to war, while defeated warriors go to war first and then seek to win. If your opponent is of choleric temper, seek to irritate him. Pretend to be weak, that he may grow arrogant. Conform to the enemy's tactics until a favorable opportunity offers. Then come forth and engage in a battle that shall prove decisive. One mark of a great soldier is that he fights in his own terms, or fights not at all. He who is prudent and lies in wait for an enemy who is not will be victorious. He will win who prepared himself, waits to take the enemy unprepared. To know your enemy, you must become your enemy. Success in warfare is gained by carefully accommodating ourselves to the enemy's purpose. Disorder came from order. Fear came from courage, and weakness came from strength. So in war, the way is to avoid the strong. What is strong? And strike at what is weak. The art of war, then, is governed by 5 constant factors to be taken into account in one's deliberations when seeking to determine the conditions obtaining in the field. These are: 1. The moral law. 2. Heaven. 3. Earth. 4. The commander. 5. Method and discipline. Rouse him and learn the principles of his activities or inactivity. Force him to reveal himself so as to find out his vulnerable spots. Hence, to fight and conquer in all your battles is not supreme excellence. Supreme excellence consists in breaking the enemy's resistance without fighting. When the common soldiers are too strong and their officers too weak, the result is insubordination. If you know yourself but not the enemy, for every victory gained, you will also suffer a defeat. All is fair in love and war. Ponder and deliberate before you make a move. Appear weak when you are strong, and strong when you are weak. To lift an autumn hair is no sign of great strength. To see the sun and moon is no sign of sharp sight. To hear the noise of thunder is no sign of quick ear. Attack him where he is unprepared. Appear where you are not expected. Even the finest sword plunged into salt water will eventually rust. Great results be achieved with small forces.